Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how easily you can customize the Angular Dropdown Tree component using built-in templates. This component supports several template options to customize dropdown tree items, header, and footer elements. Looking at this example, you can see the Angular Dropdown Tree popup showing employee names, designations, and images. You can also see the popup with a customized header and footer. Okay, now I will show you the steps to achieve this customization using my existing Angular Dropdown Tree application. Let me open my application where I have added the Angular Dropdown Tree with basic properties. I have bound employee details as the data source and set the placeholder property value as select an employee. Follow the link provided in the YouTube card to learn the basics of adding an Angular Dropdown Tree to an app. You can also find a reference link in the description below. Now, I will run this example using the command ng-serve. Here, you can see the dropdown tree showing employee names. Next, I will demonstrate how to add images and employee designations to the items. To customize items, first, I create a template using the ng-template tag and give it a reference name, item-template. I want to display employee name, designation, and their image in each item, so modify the existing dropdown tree data source by adding two more fields, eImage and job, with appropriate values. To access these data source fields inside the template section, let me create a temporary variable called data. Next, let's start to add images to the items. Inside this item template section, I define division and image elements with the class eImage to set custom styles to the image. Then, I add a source path for the image using a source attribute and set an alternate name for the image. Next, I am going to add employee names and their designations to the items, so let me create two more division elements with appropriate class names. Then, assign this data source fields, name, and job to the division elements using a data parameter. Following this, I want to add the CSS class to the popup element of the dropdown tree component, which allows you to customize the appearance of the popup by defining the CSS class property with the appropriate class name. Then, within this style.css file, I will add the CSS styles like padding, margin, font size to align the image and employee details. Here, you can see the dropdown tree component showing employee names, designations, and images. Now, let me show you how to add a header to the popup. Within the app component HTML file, first, I create a template using the ng-template tag and give it a reference name, header template. To display employee list as the header in the popup, I define a division element with the text, employee list. I define CSS styles for the header template like margin, padding, line height, and more to align the header text. And now, you can see the popup displaying the text, employee list, as the header. To show the total item count at the bottom of the popup, make use of the footer template. Within the dropdown tree code, first, create a template using the ng-template tag and give it a reference name, footer template. Then, I define the span element with the text, total list items 8. Here, I have shown a static count of the total list items in the footer. However, you can also display a dynamic count of the items from the data source. And add CSS styles for the footer template like border top, font size, line height, and text indent to align the footer text. Look here, the popup is displayed with the text, Total List Items 8, at the bottom. Next, I want to display all the selected items count in the dropdown tree, when one or more items are selected, through checkbox or multi-selection support. First, I will enable the checkbox in the component, by setting the Show Checkbox property to true. Next, I need to set the mode as custom, so I will navigate to the app component TS file and define a variable called mode with the value custom. Subsequently, I will create a custom template to display the count of selected items. To accomplish this, I will declare a variable called selected items template and assign the selected length using the value property with text content that will be displayed after the count. Lastly, I assign these two variables to the mode and custom template properties respectively. Following this, I would like to enable the automatic selection of relevant items when both child and parent tree items are checked or unchecked. For example, when a parent item is checked, all its child items will be automatically selected, and vice versa. To achieve this, I will define an object called component settings and set the value of the auto-check property to true. Next, I will assign this object to the tree settings property. Look here, when I select the items, the selected items count is displayed in the dropdown tree component. Finally, I will show you how to customize the dropdown tree using the No Records template. Let me define a template using the NG template tag and give it a reference name, No Records template. Then, I add a span element with the value, No Data Available, and remove all the properties from the code. Then, I remove other templates from the code. Now, when you look at the dropdown tree, the popup content displays the notification, No Data Available. In this video, I have shown you how to customize the Angular dropdown tree items and add a header and footer to the dropdown tree popup. Finally, I showed you how to customize the dropdown tree with a No Records template. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire Angular suite with the link in the description. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.